Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 2 Applied. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're, well, heading back to the den from Klamath. There are two doors in here we need to get through. As you can see, one, I've jammed the lock. Looking for more evidence for the good lady inside the, what is this? Buckner House. She wants more proof that, of what the Dunton brothers have done to Tor. And it's bound to be in that locked room. Hold on a second, guys. Sorry about that. Sneezing. Anyway, yeah, so we couldn't get in there and we ended up jamming the lock. So I'm gonna have to blow that door, I guess. I don't think that lock can be picked at all anymore. And inside Vix is a piece he needs to complete the crystal radio he's supposed to be fixing. So, for Metzger, and that's behind, apparently, behind another door at his shop, which, again, I can't get through because I only have 30% in lockpicking. So I'm going to put some major points into lockpicking the next couple levels anyway. And until then, try to find some dynamite. This looks like plastic explosives, but again, behind another door that I can't pick my way through. Really frustrating. Back to the den. We're a little more powerful now with our Desert Eagle, and we have an encounter already. Some farmers defending against some geckos. Alright, well, I'll help them out. You see a lean, tanned woman. You notice she has a farmer's tan. A young child. Well, the child has almost as many hit points as the mother. At least, a woman. The boy is 21. This guy is just running. He's running, and he has a submachine gun with 30 shots. Why is he running? He's the one who's armed. Okay, these are... okay, some kind of gecko. Tough little gecko. Tough little gecko. Golden gecko. Okay. Gonna stand my ground. Gonna stand my ground. In fact, matter of fact, I'll step up to protect them. I'm such a good girl. Where's your mama now? She says. Is she talking to the geckos? Is that kid running up to them? Tough little gecko was hit for 12 hit points. Now I keep getting these extra animations, which I'm gonna have to, I'm just not sure, guys, if I... the only way to remove the animations is to completely uninstall the mod and then reinstall. And I just hope that's not gonna corrupt my saves. I have to play all this stuff all over again. But yeah, I don't think I can go through the whole game like this. There's no, like, preferences thing that I can go in to just deactivate them. I have to reinstall the whole thing. Or uninstall the whole thing, sorry. This one has 23 hit points. That one has 31. And the golden gecko is unharmed. Let's see, can I... I don't want him to attack the kid. Run, kid! The farmer's out of ammo. Oh, she's punching them. Okay, at least the kid... the kid's all the way over there, good. Will you help your family? You have a... gun... a wild dog? They were attacked by a wild dog as well? I thought that was the family dog. I'd like to pick off whoever I... whichever one I can. Get the numbers down a little. Tough little gecko, hit for 20 hit points. It has 3 hit points left. Lady, punch that one. Kids continuing to run, as is the father, and she is. Okay, good. Yeah, missing whole frames of animation here. They just disappear. You guys are probably seeing it the same. They run after her. This one is almost dead. Fight me! Nobody's gonna take my home from me. Alright. Well, if you want no one to take from your home from you, you should fight for it. Not run away like a loser. Can't trust anyone these days. What are you talking about? Now what are they talking about? They can't trust anyone. Did I hit someone by mistake? I don't think I did. Were they showing up red before? I'm fighting for you guys. What are you talking about? Let's get rid of this one. Get the added AC here. I just keep restarting, guys, because I think it's messing up the audio-video sync. Nice! Alright. Now, guys, I'm running after the gecko now, not you. I ain't dying for this. Can't get me. 10% chance. Not good enough. Still when I got closer. Maybe this wasn't a good idea. I can't shoot it now. Get off my land. Well, you guys are running off the map. Can't trust anyone these days. They might run over here. Let me try to anticipate. No, not off. Oh! She ran off the map. Damn it. Oh well. Here's a mole rat. I can't reload? Oh, I'm out of bullets, aren't I? I'm out of rounds, rather. A pig rat. Oh, I thought there was a baby one. They run pretty crazy around, don't they? Somehow I missed. Seven hit points. Ow! These things hit hard. Oh, 26 hit points this thing has? Greater mole rat. Alright. I'll take these. Let me get some distance, I guess. Not much. That's still got two attacks in. That one got one. Ow, man. And I think I have one round left. Ow. 10 hit points. Gotta take another one. In fact, I'll take one of these. And one of these. Get a little more distance. These were a lot tougher than the mole rats in the original game. Unless I was just weaker at that point. 10 hit points, this is the one we want. Oh, I'm out of ammo, aren't I? Yep. I'm gonna put this ammo in. I wonder if reload would have worked there, since it was empty. They're beating me up! I missed. Ow. Thirteen hit points. Let's head straight down. Jeez. Damn. Huh. They're kicking my butt. I really need that armor. I hate to keep taking them, but... ugh. I think I need them. Damn. That's a lot of money. A lot of money you cost me. How's it doing? One hit point? You couldn't just kill it for me. Couldn't just let it die. Damn. Now, I don't suppose these carry anything, though. 400 XP. Gotta say, a lot more interesting special encounters. I realize there's two more still up there, so let me look around here first. There's at least two more. Hopefully I find some stim packs or something, though. Skull pole. A plow designed to be dragged by a Brahmin. Anything in here? Come on, you can search them. Put something in for me. Nope. Ah, nasty thing. Cool. Oh, here it comes. No surprise I missed with 27% chance. Oh, I can go again. Look how it ducks like that. Yeah, it's getting closer. I knew it would. 14 points. Actually hit it. Gonna continue to putting distance here. Because they hit hard. Ah! Missed again. Right on top of me. Ah, awesome. I don't think there's any more here. Nope, I think we're safe now. I'd see them highlighted here, but... yeah, I think we're good. Sweet. Stuff. Random encounters this time. What is this? A well. A typical well found in a wasteland. Can I use the well? Dunno. I guess I looked in all these places. All three? Or two? There's another one here. Did I look in this one? I think I looked in all of them. Okay. Now, I do not have a lot of ammo for this thing, unfortunately. This is it? What's in the gun? I'm gonna have to buy some more of that. Yeah, definitely not selling that in Klamath, that's for sure. I didn't see anything gun-related. Except for underneath the city, which... the town. Something happened. Let's go to residential. Again. Well, I gain 1%. Oh, I'm getting my stuff back from that. I'm just gonna hang out. Because I want to be able to see things and go places, go in places and stuff like that. I don't know if those people will take offense to us going in the middle of the night. One more hour. Basically almost the same. The colors are fading! What was that? Alright, so... places. Residential, so I'm guessing these are all just houses. Mom is a great lady, isn't she? Nice to see you. A small girl. Hi, miss. Can I go in here? As long as it's not locked. No one seems to be taking offense to us going in places. What? No? I want to go in the room. Bathroom? I don't think I'm gonna find it. I'm not gonna search through the bookcases with them standing there. So. Well, unfortunately, the toilet is very clean. And the sink is in perfect condition. Well, at least you guys have a nice bathroom. I approve. Have a good day. Oh, there's something in here. Don't you do that. What am I doing? Blood. No one's here? The sheets have not been changed in a very long time. Let's see what the bookcase. Nothing. I gotta say one thing for them. They keep their toilets very clean. Definitely want to check out what that is. This chair is falling apart. Quickly. Nothing. Nothing. A sledgehammer. 10mm jacket at hollow point. Alright. A 10mm pistol and a knife. Alright, I got all that stuff. girly poster. Alright, so it's the edge of the map here. People selling drugs there. These two houses I've been in. Mailbox empty. So I've got two houses here. Oh, one big one. And one torn apart place over there. Probably has nothing in it. Alright, let's check out over here. Oh, I see the door. There's some beer in there I may or may not be able to take. Hi, miss. My name's Bobby, and I live here with my dad. I see. Well, that... Are you here because my dad owes you money? I don't know if he's here or not, but if I knew where he was, I'd tell you. Because maybe you'd beat him up so bad, he wouldn't ever come home again. Oh. It sounds like you're not too fond of your dad. Mind if I ask why? Because my dad's not very nice. He leaves me home alone all the time, and when he is home, he's always drunk or he says he's flying on jet, which is a lie because I never see him fly anywhere. Sometimes he brings a girlfriend home. He's got lots of girlfriends. And he makes me go outside for a while, even if it's the middle of the night and it's cold or raining. That's... Oh, and sometimes he tells me to take things from people in secret. He says it's a game and that he gives it back later, but I don't believe him. But if I don't do it, then he gets real mad and his eyes get all scary looking. And he hurts me, see? He lifts up his shirt sleeve, revealing a nasty bruise on his arm. Oh god, that's second choice. No way. That sounds horrible, Bobby. Your father has no right to treat you that way. No parent does. His eyes light up. You aren't like the others that come through here. I like you. I wish my dad was more like you. Sometimes I think about running away. Some of my friends don't have homes, and they say it's not so bad. As long as they bring Mr. Flick enough things, they get to eat once a day. But Mr. Flick doesn't sound very nice either. Actually, he sounds a lot like my dad. There's got to be something that can be done about this. Can you think of any adults in this town that'd be willing to look after you? Or any of these homeless kids? Bobby shrugs. Maybe Mom? I don't mean my mom. My mom's dead. But there's a lady that people call Mom. I don't know why. Maybe because she's really nice? She's got a diner on the other side of town. He points to the northeast. Well... Oh, yeah. Forgot to... My homeless friends go there, and she sneaks them free food. I wish Dad would take me there, because she knows how to make a rat taste really yummy. I am feeling a bit hungry. Perhaps I'll go pay Mom a visit. You take care of yourself, Bobby. Hi again. Did you talk to the mom lady? Don't worry, Bobby. I'm working on it. Alright. First, let me look around. Lower the ground mutants. Oh, is that him? What? Middle-aged man. Hick. Do I know you? It's 11 o'clock. Do you know where your children are? Looks at you sleepily. What? Hick. It's 11 already? Actually, no, it isn't. I just wanted to say that, but seriously, do you know where your children are? Hick. I have children? Hick. Oh, yeah, I do. He? Or is it she? Hick. Should be around here somewhere. Wow, you're such a drunk. Well, good thing I'm working on a way to get your child out of here. Ignores what you just said. Yeah, that's great. Hick. Now, let me get back to this drink. Alright, then. Well, I'm not going to take the drinks right in front of him. I don't want to get him pissed off. I'm going to visit Mom after I look at this place. A wooden door. It looks like a wooden door. It opens. And inside we see... There's a lot of stuff over there. There's no one in this room, though, so we can look around. Empty. Bookcase. Empty. Not too surprising. Very nice chair, though. Hey! What's going on here? Got a party going on? Squatter? Huh? Got anything to eat? Have you seen my dog? Huh? Well, let me go in here first. There are a couple of stains of dubious origin on this well-worn sleeping device. That's one thing to call it. Nuka-Cola, grabbed it. Nothing in here. Toilet's very clean. Someone must, like, service these places. Even the urinal is in perfect condition. Who would've thunk it? Yeah, let's go and talk to these people first. What do you want? Never mind. Huh. Interesting, we can even get into a dialogue. You squatting here too? I'm just gonna look through stuff. And this isn't their place, so I think it's okay. They've probably looked through it already. Anyway. Well, I'm gonna take this beer. And you guys have a great day. Anything over here? Wait, nope, nope. Nothing. Alright. I can't see. Again. What is this? No, what is that? Meat jerky? Oh, chat? They're probably so, like, out of it, they don't even notice me taking all their stuff. Alright. Have a great day now. Alright, let's check this burned out, blasted area. There's probably nothing. Nothing here. Thought there might be a bookcase or something. There's just one way out. Alright. Alright, so is this the east? Or is this the west side? Okay, so that's the east side and that's out. Let's go talk to Mom. So here, have I been down there? Does that also go to residential section? Maybe, maybe not. Where's Mom? That's a customer. Oh, this is the hole. This isn't the diner. Isn't the diner more down this way? Let me just put my gun away. I've been walking around with it out the whole time. Oh, this is her? Yeah. What did you want to talk to Mom about? I noticed there seems to be a lot of orphans around town. It's a shame, isn't it? Those poor children living on the streets like that. A lot of them steal to get by. From outsiders, mostly. So if you catch one trying to relieve you of something, please take pity on him. I'm not saying it's right, but it's a harsh world we live in, and we all do what we have to in order to make it through the day. There's got to be something we can do about this. From what I hear, you seem to be the only person around that actually gives a damn about those kids. Why, of course I do. Children are our future. We are the world. They don't have to grow up to be jetheads, thugs, and whores like most of their deadbeat parents. Why, with an education and some love and care, these kids could grow into the kind of decent folk that we so desperately need in this world. I've tried establishing an orphanage for them, but sadly that didn't pan out. Maybe it's time to give it another try. I'm not going to be in town for too much longer, but I'll do what I can to help while I'm here. Yes, perhaps you could help. You see, I procured a large building over on the southwest side that, with a little work, would make an excellent orphanage. But a bunch of lowlifes are squatting there and refuse to leave unless I pay an absurd fee. Oh, we just met them. Even if I had the money, I wouldn't give it to those bullies. They just use it to further poison themselves. I'd go to the authorities, but unfortunately there's no such thing in the den. Perhaps you'd have a better luck at convincing them to leave? That's that guy that we couldn't say anything to. Okay, we're supposed to talk to him. Got it. I'm sure I could get them out of there, one way or another. I'll let you know once they're gone. Sweet. Alright. Oh, that goes out. This goes out, probably to, yeah. Outside town. Let me just check. Yep. Alright, let's go right to residential then. There's a door here.